The hotel, this is Dan speaking. How may I help you?
Well, hello there, young man.
Hello there, sir.
My name is Frank, and I'm going to be staying at your hotel in the very near future. And I have a few questions.
Oh, of course. What can I help you with?
First of all, what time is it right now?
Well, sir, we're on the East Coast time, so it kind of depends on where you're calling from.
Okay, so you're on East Coast time.
That is correct. Where are you calling from, sir?
You know, I find time zones fascinating. Don't you?
Yes, they can be fairly confusing.
Do you know that Putin killed a number of time zones back in Russia years ago?
I did not realize that.
Putin killed some time zones. There used to have 16 or so.
Huh.
But now, well, only 11. And that is still leading the world in time zones. Can you believe that?
Yeah, I did not know that.
Can you believe it?
Yeah, that's interesting. I did not know that.
If we can get back to my question about the hotel.
Of course.
Do you have a preferred prostitute service?
Excuse me, sir?
Well, because I need to know the time at your hotel to order the prostitutes when they should arrive. The thing about prostitutes is they're very specific on time, you know.
I did not know that, sir, and I don't think I can help you with that. I'm sorry.
Well, maybe I'm not being clear. I'm talking about, you know, hookers. I need a few.
I understand that, sir. I just don't think that it's appropriate for me to be helping you with that specific issue.
You know,
through the hotel.
I used to arrange prostitutes for Putin back in the day. I bet you didn't know that.
I did not know that, sir.
And that was a tough one with all of those time zones.
Oh, yeah, so we're back to the time zones again.
Well,
okay.
As I was saying, prostitutes are very particular about time.
Yeah, so I can imagine.
I would call them and they'd say, "What time is it there?" And I don't know that information.
Because of the time zones.
Yeah, well, current day, and when I was working for Putin, setting up his prostitutes.
Sounds like you've had quite a life, sir. But is there anything else I can help you with in terms of the hotel?
It was so confusing. I mean, there were prostitutes showing up all hours of the day and night. One time, I found a hooker in the library. And I was like, "How'd you get in here?" Because, you know, I didn't even know that they read books.
Well, sir, I would love to talk to you more about your life and the prostitutes, but
a lot of people don't know, prostitutes, avid readers, almost all of them.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
Can I help you with anything else, sir, in terms of the hotel?
Well, you know, my wife's a prostitute. And, she'll be accompanying me on the trip, so if you'd like a turn, I could be happy to set that up for you.
No, that won't be necessary.
What was your name? What was your name again, sir?
My name is Dan, sir.
Dan, I'll just send my wife down once I get in, and she'll ask for you at the desk.
That is not necessary, sir. That is definitely not necessary.
She'll be the one in negligee, and probably a book in her hand.
Please.
Avid reader.
Please don't. That is completely unnecessary. In fact, I think I would get in trouble here at the hotel if you sent your prostitute wife to see me. I would really not appreciate
so
that.
So you'd like to come up to the room?
No, I'm absolutely not coming up to your room, sir.
Well, I could just kind of hang out and...
Okay, that's enough.
View the festivities from an office chair in the corner.
That will not be happening, sir.
You wouldn't mind shouting an insult or two at me. That would make the experience better.
You know what, sir? I'm feeling very uncomfortable right now, and I think I may have to let you go, sir.
Well, I should maybe let you know before that happens that your friend Todd wanted me to call you.
My friend Todd?
Yes, you have a friend named Todd, right?
Yes, I do have a friend named Todd, but what does he have to do with this?
He's big into prostitutes and prank phone calls.
Excuse me?
Oh, this is actually Jubal from Brook and Jubal in the Morning doing a phone tap on you. Your friend Todd set you up. He told me you work at a hotel, and every time you get an old person on the phone, they talk forever. So he wanted me to prank you.
It's so true.
Well, they have all kinds of stories, interesting ones.
I almost lost it with the whole prostitutes and the reading books.
They love it. Shakespeare is their thing.